Blue Valley, and welcome to our November edition of Tiger TV. Today we are making history with Blue Valley's first ever live newscast from our news studio. I'm Natalie Pace.
And I'm Henry McGrew. Tweet us throughout the broadcast at BVHS Broadcast, and you may get a shout out at the end of the show.
The first story of our show is a heartfelt one. A Blue Valley athlete was blindsided by a twist of fate earlier this year.
That's right, Natalie. The sophomore is experiencing bad headaches that eventually led to some unfortunate news. I got the details on the situation.
Brian Shrum is a member of the Tiger baseball and football team. Last fall, Shrum started to experience severe headaches that some thought were football related. The symptoms got worse earlier this season. Brian's parents, Brad and Kitty, took Brian to get an MRI and Brian's tumor was found.
Well, I had a lot of headaches, like bad migraine headaches, and so we went into a doctor and then we got an MRI and we found out that way.
Well, we had surgery done on the 10th of October, and they went just back here, they made an incision, and they cut out a part of the skull and just took it out.
The Shrum shared with us what it was like emotionally to go through this process.
Well, originally it was pretty devastating, actually, because when the MRI was going to be done, we thought that it would come back and just show, you know, maybe migraine symptoms. You're not really prepared for, you know, that it's a brain tumor. You really can't be prepared for it.
I mean, I didn't really know until we got the MRI back. I came home from school and my mom was home, and then we waited until my dad got home to tell me. And I mean, it's pretty sad because, you know, football's over, everything. I mean, and we went to the doctor and found out we had to get surgery to remove it.
Well, when you find out something like this about your child, it's so such an emotional roller coaster to have to know. You've got to go home and tell your child he has a brain tumor, but you don't know at that point if it's benign or if you're going to go through cancer. You know, it's unbelievably hard for a parent. But
the Shrums are a very close and strong family. They shared with us what emotionally helped them through this process.
I think our faith in God, mostly, because without that, you wouldn't be able to face anything like this. We had great support from the Blue Valley Football Club, the baseball club, the school itself was just totally awesome. We really, and I don't know of any grown man that would have handled it as well as Brian did. His strength gave us strength to get through the whole process.
Right before the October operation, Coach Driscoll brought a team autographed football to Brian in the hospital. Head football coach Eric Driscoll shared his thoughts on Brian.
Oh, Brian Shum's a great kid. He's just a good human being, good football player, good student, but he's just a good person. I've never met anybody that said a negative thing about him.
The surgery was a success, and tests revealed the tumor was benign. The Shrums shared with us their thoughts on the good news.
Oh, it was great, because, I mean, not cancerous, and it was one and done. You don't have to worry about it.
Mm-hmm. What was it for you guys?
Well, I tell you, we kind of had peace from God all along that it was going to turn out like this. We felt like that Jesus was with us from the start, not only walking with us, but walking before us, that he knew what was ahead for us. And honestly, it was to get the benign was a tremendous relief. But Dr. Camarada had kind of let us know ahead of time, this is what he thought it was, is benign. Mm-hmm. So we had a lot of peace about it before the official. But to get it official is kind of beyond words, to be honest with you. You know, it's we don't know what the future holds with sporting activities. We're a big hunting family. We don't know what that holds. But we know that we feel the worst of this is behind us.
If all goes as planned, Brian hopes to be on this field playing baseball next spring. With photographer Mazen Ockel, Henry McGrew, Tiger TV.
Our hearts go out to Brian Shrum and his family.
As Brian recovers, we'd like to see our school recover too.
Josh Crestine looked into why BV's ceiling tiles are dripping wet.
Blue Valley High School has been around for 3 decades and has been showing signs of its wear and tear. You might have noticed water damage in the hallways or classrooms. Trash cans collecting water in the 200 hall, or water now leaking into the lights. Blue Valley has more holes in it than a slice of Swiss cheese. Water had poured into the computer room, and ceiling tiles are now off, with plastic covering all the equipment. During last week's downpour, Tiger TV's control room started to have a leak also.
We understand that the roof has been leaking in here over the past couple years. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, it's an old building, and the old building's got old leaks. They're throughout the building. And when one stops, a new one develops. So, leaking has always been a problem here. And originally, when this building was built, they added on to it over the years. And whenever you have an add-on, they're susceptible to leaks.
So how long have you been working in your room?
In this room, I've been in, I think, about 5 years.
When did you first notice the problem?
That room has leaked as long as I've worked in this building. Prior to moving into that classroom, Mrs. Henry taught in there, and it leaked the whole time she was in there. And I've been in the building for 9 years, so I know that at least that long it has leaked.
Last week, when did you first realize it was leaking?
It was after school, probably about 3:30, 4 o'clock. I was grading papers. It was really quiet in my room, and I just started hearing this drip, drip, drip on the ceiling tile on the other side of the room, and I've heard it before. I knew exactly what it was.
What did you have to do to get it fixed?
I had to walk around and find custodians. They weren't available, so I had to go to Mrs. Wood in the office, and she got on a walkie-talkie and called the custodians to go take a look, and Mr. Mountain met me at the room, and he said he didn't want to take the tiles out because he was afraid that would cause a bigger problem. It would just make all of the water pour. So I believe he was thinking that those tiles were kind of catching the water. Since it was right up next to the wall where my projection screen is, we took the screen down, and so that stayed down for about a week until the water wasn't dripping anymore.
In the words of Henry Longfellow, the best thing one can do when it's raining is to let it rain. One thing he didn't tell us is to have a bucket handy. Photographer Logan Patel, Josh Crestine, Tiger TV.
What do you think the new kids think of the dripping ceilings?
What new kids?
You know, the new kids from the elite hockey teams. Nick Felling introduced the new players.
This year, sophomore Jeff Stack and junior Zach Bennett moved here to Blue Valley to play hockey for the Kansas City Mavericks junior elite team. Sophomore Caleb Ernst was already on the team at the time when Jeff and Zach moved here. Jeff Stack moved here from Cedar Rapids, Iowa, and is living with Ernst. Zach Bennett moved here from Raleigh, North Carolina, and is living with sophomore Aaron Peterson, who is his cousin. Zach is also one of the team's goalies. Caleb Ernst is a right wing, which means he passes the puck to the other players on his scoring position. Tiger TV talked to these elite hockey players about their goals and their families.
It's a more competitive league, better chances to get scouted for colleges, juniors, that type of stuff.
Pretty much what you said. It's just better competition, better skill level, more scouts to look at you, and just a better chance to play college hockey.
It's great. He's great around the house. He's good team, hardworking. He's just good around, yeah.
It's nice. It's definitely an adjustment, but they're really nice, and Aaron's a good kid to hang out with. He's coming a really, really good new friend, so it's a fun place to live, so I like it.
With photographer Eric Aubuchon, Nick Felling, Tiger TV.
Pass.
Shoot.
Score.
Pass.
Shoot and score.
Pass, shoot and score.
Yeah. There you go.
Yeah. So,
it's so great they're following their dreams of hockey to different states.
My dream has always been to be a Pokemon trainer.
Really?
Hey, I'm not the only one. Vlad Blicken checked up on these Pokemon experts.
Pokemon X and Pokemon Y are Nintendo 3DS games that were released on October 12th this year worldwide. Some Blue Valley students got their hands on them after the release. The goal of the series is to train the Pokemon to make them stronger, while defeating the Elite Four in the process. X and Y introduces 69 new Pokemon, which brings the total number to 718. Tiger TV caught up with Pokemon trainers around Blue Valley High School to see what they think about Pokemon X and Y. What version of Pokemon did you choose?
I chose Pokemon X.
Why do you like playing Pokemon?
It's really entertaining. It's just a lot of fun, and the new games, in my opinion, I think they're like one of the best games yet. The graphics are really good.
What version of Pokemon did you choose?
Pokemon Y.
Why do you like playing Pokemon?
Ever since I was a kid, I've always been playing Pokemon. It grew on me, and I just like being able to raise my Pokemon. It's a very fun kind of game.
Every Thursday morning, Pokemon fans at Blue Valley meet in the Fix Forum to play the game with others and to discuss the plot of the games. So which will you choose, Pokemon X or Pokemon Y? With photographer Alex Voorhees, Brad Blicken, Tiger TV.
Pokemon's great, but it's no fun without the right console. I've been waiting for the next generation stuff to come out.
The what?
They have way better graphics and way better gameplay.
What does that even mean?
Josh Washington educated these players.
The PlayStation 4 and Xbox One have been in production for 5 years now, under the codenames Orbis and Durango. Next-gen systems will run at 60 frames per second compared to current-gen systems running at only 40 frames per second. The main difference between the two systems is the PlayStation 4 will have a faster processor, making the loading time 10 times faster than the Xbox One. Another key factor is the cost of the two systems. The PlayStation 4 will cost consumers $399.99, while the Xbox One costs an extra $100 at $499.99. Also, Xbox One products will cost consumers an average of $33 more than PlayStation 4 products. You can hear the consumers' reaction when they announce the prices for the two systems.
Okay.
Tiger TV got a few students' opinion on which systems they would be getting.
I prefer the PlayStation 4 because it comes out sooner, it's got a better processor, and it's cheaper.
Xbox One, because Xbox One is ranked number one and PS4 is number four.
Getting the Xbox One, and I don't know, I had the Xbox 360, so that was fun.
All local retailers have been sold out of these consoles for a few months. So any eager gamers wanting to get their hands on the systems may have a waiting time of up to 3 months. With photographer Don Jacobson, Josh Washington, Tiger TV.
Name this movie, Luke, I Am Your Father.
Oh, that's easy! Star Trek.
Oh my gosh. Go to Hall Pass.
Notebook.
It's the Nicholas Sparks movie, I'm pretty sure. Are you
guys? Crap.
Wait, Darling? Is that what you
that,
said?
I know that.
I have no idea.
Movie?
It's a chick flick.
Gatsby? No idea. The Notebook? Titanic.
Gatsby.
Oh, Great Gatsby. Toy Story? No. Tangled.
It's from The Incredibles.
Yeah.
The next book.
15 years ago, maybe, but now.
Oh, what do you mean? You designed it.
I never look back, darling. It distracts from the now.
Is it returning from the past?
Back to the future.
Yes.
Oh.
Back to the future.
Yes.
Yay!
Yay! Hey Doc, we better back up. We don't have enough road to get up to 88.
Roads? Where we're going, we don't need roads.
clue, honestly.
Fired up.
Life of Pi! Tigers! Darn it.
Secondhand Lions.
God, that's... Mary Poppins.
Blades of Glory?
We bought a zoo.
Wizard of Oz.
Zoolander!
Winnie the Pooh.
Is it...
No.
Is it...
His name's Tigger, not Tiger.
SpongeBob movie.
Oh.
Hangover.
Oh, actually, I've never seen The Hangover.
Why are you peppering the steak? You don't know if tigers like pepper.
Tigers love pepper. They hate cinnamon.
We can light it up, up, up. I love the teachers at this school. I learn a lot from them.
We are pretty spoiled. In fact, one of our own teachers was chosen to attend a conference with teachers around the nation to share ideas and resources. Tiger TV's Ellie Fehlig got the story.
John Holloway traveled to Seattle, Washington on Monday, November 4th for a teachers' conference at the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. The conference was for teachers across the nation to get together and collaborate on ideas and teaching styles. There were only two teachers in the Blue Valley School District chosen to participate.
I think they wanted somebody who was an experienced teacher, somebody who's technology a fair amount, somebody who's attractive, and I think I met all the requirements.
Holloway believes the foundation can do a lot of good for teachers and will continue to improve education. With photographer Josh Washington, Ellie Fehlig, Tiger TV.
What are you wearing?
It's my Halloween costume.
Henry, Halloween is long gone.
You've got to be dedicated and persistent to win a costume contest.
Oh gosh, I looked into the costume contest at Blue Valley.
The Blue Valley Art Club has set up a contest to test the creativity of students and see who had the best Halloween costume. The costume contest took place from October 22nd to November 4th, and the costumes will be judged on scariest, funniest, and overall best. The winners will receive a percentage of the entry fees as a cash reward. We talked with contest participant Grace Hunter to see how she came up with her costume.
I was a scare at Fear Farm. I worked in a haunted house, and when I got there, they did my makeup for me. It was just really cool, so I thought I would send a picture of it in.
The Art Club plans to continue the contest for years to come. The winners will be announced later this week. With photographer Ellie Fehlig, Natalie Pace, Tiger TV.
Speaking of Halloween, did you go to the Spooky Dookie dance, Henry?
Unfortunately, no, but I heard it was quite the party. Tiger TV's Elliot Felly got the highlights.
My life be like, yeah, ooh. My life be like, yeah, ooh. Yeah, ooh. My life be like, yeah, ooh. My life be like, times like these.
My heart skipped, skipped.
What's wrong, Natalie?
I hate this next door. Horses freak me out.
Don't be such a baby. They're only ponies. Joe Flinza wrote up the question club. Oh.
The Equestrian Club is a brand new club that is sponsored by 4. They meet every other Monday in 504 where they talk about and plan horse-related services that they can provide to the community.
Yeah. What would our price be?
$1.50. Recently planned a bake sale to raise money for a farm. You don't need a horse to participate in this club.
We had a bunch of students that didn't ride, so they came out and they see horses.
Now, for the first time ever, let's turn it over to Logan Bertel with weather.
Over to you, Logan.
Oh, hello, Blue Valley. Welcome. Welcome to the first ever edition of Tiger TV Weather Live. I am honored to be your first ever weatherman, Logan Bertel. Let's take a look here at the radar. This is a map of the United States. And in those United States, we have a few light showers up in the northern part regarding the Nebraska-South Dakota area and a few in Michigan. Now, regarding the Kansas City Metro Overland Park area, we shouldn't have any trouble today. Maybe a few light shower set later tonight. But for the most part, the light showers are going to be up in the northern part. So if you have any relatives, just know that they're going to be receiving some rain. Today, we have a high of 50 degrees, but no chance of rain. It's going to be looking good. Tonight, however, it's going to go down to 36. No chance of rain, but you're going to want to break out those coats later tonight. Tomorrow, it's going to be a great day for football. We have a game tomorrow night. A high of 56, a 10% chance of rain, but we're not expecting that, and a 14-mile-an-hour wind. It should look good, though. Saturday, it's going to warm up this weekend. A high of 62 degrees with a few light showers here and there. A high of 65 on Sunday, and it's going to get colder next week with a high of 49 on Monday and a high of 38 on Tuesday with a low of 25. It's going to get pretty cold down there. Let's go back to you, Henry and Natalie, in the studio. We'll see you later.
Thanks, Logan. Blue Valley, this has been our very first live broadcast of Tiger TV.
A quick shout-out to Ashlyn Summer and Olivia Taylor.
And Mikey Henson and Morgan Turner.
For tweeting us during the broadcast.
Now it's off to Zach Williams and Josh Washington for overtime.
See you next semester.
Yeah, man, it's sad.
So, me and you aren't going to be working together anymore.
Start over. What's up, Blue Valley, and welcome to the third and final edition of Overtime for the semester. I'm Zach Williams.
And I'm Josh Washington. Zach, did you say this is our last edition of Overtime?
Yeah, man, it's pretty sad.
So, me and you won't be working together anymore?
No.
Dude, that's awesome. Oh, God. Zach, I didn't mean like that, but, Zach got the story on volleyball.
The Blue Valley volleyball team traveled to the Topeka Expo Center November 1st and 2nd to compete in the 6A state volleyball tournament. After an outstanding 26-8 regular season record, the team was the 2 seed for the tournament. Tigers advanced to the semifinals with wins over Mays and Manhattan, but unfortunately lost a very close game to number 1-seeded Olathe East in the third set. Team kept their heads up, though, quickly defeating Olathe Northwest in 2 sets to win the third place title.
My girls played hard and just had a couple breaks, didn't get a couple breaks into their court and took care of our business here, so I'm proud of my girls. I am extremely excited for my seniors' career in college. Both my seniors are going to college play. I'm excited for Meg Kennedy. I'm going to miss them dearly. These are the first 4 girls, varsity girls, I've ever coached, and I love them dearly. They're like my daughters, so I'm very happy for them, and yet I'm sad to see them go. It's been an emotional time for me.
We're proud of our team. We fought hard, taking home a medal tonight, so it's good to end with the W.
I love you, Liz.
You guys are number 1 in my heart. Go, Liz.
Right here. You guys are the best.
Ooh, kill him.
That was masculine.
Zach Williams, Overtime. Congratulations to the volleyball team on their success this year. Josh, we're recording.
Sorry about that, Blue Valley. In other news, the soccer team had one of the best seasons in school history this year. My boy Zach Williams got the story.
The boys' soccer season recently came to a close as the team lost to Shawnee Mission East in the regional finals. The team was disappointed in this early loss after a very successful 12-4 regular season. Yet, even without great postseason success, the team will go down as one of Blue Valley's best teams ever. Along with a great winning season, 2 members of the team set new school records. Senior Sam Rasopoulos beat the school record for assists in a season with 15, and senior Ben McDonald followed in his 2 older brothers' footsteps, setting the school record for goals in a season with 23. All of Blue Valley's athletic programs have had a lot of success this season.
Cross country is no exception. Both teams made it to state, and Sam Jacobson got this story.
October 26, 20 of Blue Valley's top cross country runners traveled to Lawrence for the 6A state championship. Both the boys and girls teams qualified for state, sending 10 members each. This is the first time that both teams have made it to state for 6A since Coach Diana Huber started coaching. With the boys' race starting at 10:30, they met to get pumped up before the race. When the race started, Joe Gorthy rushed out and led the pack for the first mile. Gorthy ended up finishing with a time of 16 minutes and 58 seconds. 2012 cross-country state champion Colton Donahue was at the event cheering on his old team. Nathan Patterson had a few questions for him.
You got to put all out on the course, all right? How do you think they're going to do?
I think I can do it. I'm ready. I'm focused. This injury is nothing to me, but I know I can win. I can pull this off.
The girls' race followed at 12:30. The ladies went through the same ritual as the boys, warming up and meeting in the last huddle of the year. When the gun sounded, the girls were off. Freshman Kelsey Kincaid and senior Rachel Campbell led the Tigers. As a team, the boys placed 7th and the girls placed 10th. Blue Valley has had their best season yet and blown all expectations out of the water. Sam Jacobson, overtime.
One.
Josh, again? We're recording.
100.
Sorry about that, Zach. I was trying to get big and swole like the football team.
I got the story. On Friday, November 1st, the Tiger football team hosted the district championship against rival school Blue Valley West. The new stadium was packed full of fans from both schools for an exciting night of football. Tigers defense came out strong at the start of the game, forcing the Jaguars to punt after just three plays. They kept the pressure on, recovering a backwards pass on the 50-yard line the very next drive. Most of the first quarter was spent in a scoring stalemate until the Tigers offense broke through with a 28-yard field goal by Logan Bertel. The Tigers continued by extending the lead to 10 in the second quarter with a touchdown pass to Mikey Henson over the top of a West defender. West came back, breaking defenders for a long 65-yard touchdown run to put the score at 10-6, missing the extra point attempt. Tigers responded, though, with Montana Brady rushing in for a 9-yard TD after just three plays. Team went into halftime, up 17-6. Ball security hurt the Tigers in the second half with the Jaguars recovering three fumbles. West gained momentum, scoring 9 points and closing the lead to 2 in the fourth quarter. With the clock running out, West completed a 25-yard field goal to go up by 1. The final score, Blue Valley West 18, Blue Valley 17. The Tigers, though angered by this close loss, still advanced to the state playoffs with their first game against Shawnee Heights. Here are some of the highlights. Zach Williams, overtime.
Take it to the ground. Don't too many make it coming through our town. Looking for a detour, nowhere to be found. When the pressure's on, seems nobody's around. But I won't let them see me sweat. Yeah, it took a little time, but can't really be upset. Long way to the top, I could barely see the steps. Yeah, they sleeping on me still, but I barely need to rest. See me standing here, head high, face up. I don't need no x-ray, show you what I made up. Tell them I pay my dues and you could check the pay stubs. Never had a chance, so I had to go and make one. Say something. You could tell them that I've been through hell and back, but I'm home. Can't really complain when it's the life that I chose. Sacrificed it all and everything that I own. Say, what doesn't kill me can only make me stronger. You could tell them that I've been from hell and back. When the heat is on, I fire back. In this cold world, where your light is at, let's burn it down. Man, I've been from hell and back. When the heat is on, I fire back. In this cold world, where your light is at, let's burn it down, fire back. Yeah, can you feel the heat? Black as hot as ever in these city streets. You only get one shot, keep your arms steady. They tried to make me wait, but I'm more than.
Good luck to the Tiger football team as they face off against Mill Valley tomorrow night for the sectional quarterfinals. I'd also like to give a shout out to Sam Virgilito for taking video against Shawnee Heights.
Well, Blue Valley, thanks for watching the first live edition of Overtime. Also, good luck to the winter sports as they begin their seasons. Signing off one last time, I'm Josh Washington.
I'm Zach Williams. Overtime.